This is the BeatBot AquaSense robotic pool cleaner. This thing can run for over 3 hours, cleaning both the floor and the walls of your pool. It's got 4 brushes that rotate independently, 3 different motors, weighs about 20 pounds, even has this cool little dock where you can place on it. That's actually where it charges. You don't have to plug anything physically to the robot. And I've been using it over the last few days, and this thing cleans really well. Also, I know there's a little bit of an awkward angle. I wasn't sure how to get this thing in the pool and myself, but I'm going to commit to the bit, so here I am. In the box, it's pretty simple. You get the robot. Again, it's about 20 pounds, pretty easy to carry. It has a handle for you to pick it up, and also comes with a little plastic hook attachment. It goes onto your standard pool pole, and then you can lift it up out of the pool, but it also has this really cool feature that when it's done cleaning, it will actually go up to the waterline of your pool and stay there. It can do it for up to 10 minutes for you to grab it without having to hook it from the bottom of the pool, which is super cool. And also in the box, you have that dock, which you can just plug in, normal outlet. I've been keeping it out here on the patio, and that's where it charges. It can connect to your Wi-Fi, so you can access it for the app. I'll show you that in a minute. It also has a 305 millimeter cleaning path and a 146 millimeter extra long design. Actually, we'll be testing a couple of these pool cleaning robots, and this one is longer and a little bit larger of size, which I find really helps with the cleaning capacity, especially on the floor. So what is it like to clean with this thing? It's pretty funny. You actually just toss it in the pool. Don't toss it super hard, but you can toss it on the water. It'll float on the top for a few seconds and then slowly sink down. It regulates the air inside with going up down the walls, and then it'll just start rolling around and cleaning your pool. It's pretty cool. There's 3 different modes you can change in the app. You can have it do just the floor twice. You can have it do floors and walls, and a couple other settings that are available to you. It has 15 sensors helping it find where to clean, a 1.8 gigahertz processor, and a 200 watt brushless pump. Those are the things that help it go up the wall and then stay at the waterline in order for you to pick it up. It's designed for pretty much every pool, rectangle, circle, above, or in-ground. I have an in-ground pool here and it's pretty curvy, but it does a good job getting around all the walls and the curves. It'll struggle a little bit by the stairs and might not be able to go up multiple stairs if you have those, but overall I found it to clean well. There was actually some sand at the bottom of our pool that's been there for a long time, and this got it up. It does this N and S shape cleaning, and you can see that. I actually strapped a GoPro onto the robot once it sunk to the bottom, and I was filming the entire time it was cleaning. Pretty cool. Also seeing it come up to the waterline while it's cleaning. Once it's done cleaning, you pick it up out from the waterline or using the hook. Then you're supposed to clean the filter every time it cleans, and I did find stuff in the filter, so obviously it was definitely capturing stuff inside the robot while vacuuming around. And for my size pool, which is about 27 feet long on the longest side, it only got down to about 60 or 70% battery after every cleaning. Charges fairly quickly. You can just throw it in again. I had it cleaning multiple times a day just to test it out. You can also start it and change the cleaning mode here on the physical robot. It has a power button and then cleaning just the floor or floor and walls. Those are the 3 buttons you see at the beginning. When you take it off the dock and you're about to throw it in, you do have to let it sit for 5 seconds on a flat surface before you toss it in the pool. They said it's very important to do that. I'm not sure what happens if you don't, but I didn't want to risk it. So make sure you put it on a flat surface first, off the dock, 5 seconds, and then you could toss it in the pool. Let's talk about the app for a second. You can download the BeatBot app and pair it with your pool robot just by scanning the QR code on the front. You can attach it to the Wi-Fi network of your house, and then you can access it anywhere you are. I'll enter the device. You can see it's pretty minimalistic. It will tell you the battery right there, connected to Wi-Fi, current temperature outside, which is pretty interesting. Then you can also change the mode that it's going to clean down here. So I can go into standard mode, I can do quick mode, which just does the floor one time, or custom mode. And custom mode, you can decide whether to do the floor or wall 1 or 2 times. So if you want extra floor, but just one time wall, you can do that, or just go into the standard mode as well. You can also see the history of cleaning records right here. And you can see from my size pool, I ran it 4 times. Depending on the cleaning mode, the last time I actually did 2x walls and floors, it took about 2 hours. Before that, I did kind of a standard mode, and that was 83 minutes, so about an hour and a half. And you can go to one of those modes and see how long it was doing the floor, how long it was doing the walls, 65 versus 58 minutes. And that's pretty much it. That's all you need the app to do, but again, it works consistently well, really nicely designed. And if you really wanted to, you could add additional devices, scan it to add right here, or add device that way. And you will get notifications that cleaning has been completed. So you can see that here. Make sure you clean the filter every time. And this is what it looks like when you get one of the notifications that cleaning has been completed. It sometimes sends that after it gets to the top of the water line, but you don't have connectivity when it's in the water. So if you want to be able to manage it with the app, you do need to take it out of the water to get that full connectivity. You can get the AquaSense directly from BeatBot, or you can get it on Amazon. I'll put a link to that down in the video description. Normally, it is $12.99, which is not inexpensive, but instead of brushing your pool, which is something that I was doing a lot, having one of these robots, being able to throw it in once a week, make sure your entire pool is clean, it is super convenient. And I consider it part of a smart home. I got robots vacuuming the inside of my house. Now there's robots vacuuming the outside. Well, at least the pool. It is on sale right now for $10.99, so you can get $200 off whether you order from Amazon or directly from BeatBot. Again, links are down in the video description. That sale is going on till May 10th, so if you want to grab that, make sure you do. And subscribe to the channel because we are heading into summertime. I'm here in Florida, so it's been hot already, like in the 80s and 90s degrees. But I'm going to be doing some other pool tech, like things that can automatically measure the chemicals in your pool, salination and chlorine, plus other robotic pool vacuums if you're into that. So subscribe to the channel. I also have a ton of other smart home content. I do an entire tour of my smart home. I'll link that video above. You can check out all the automations that I have set up. And I have some new smart shades that I'll be using as well with Matter and Thread. So stay tuned for those. And if you want to learn more about shortcuts automations, automating things on your iPhone, your AirPods, your battery life to make the most of that, I'll put another one of those videos over there as well. If you have any questions, leave a comment below the video. Hit that like button before you go. And thanks for watching. I'm going to get off the floor now.